So this video will help you in solving edXL IGCSE May-June 2019 paper 1 FR foundation. Let's start. Before we begin solving the paper, let me tell you this video is not just providing you with answers. This video will also help you in solving these questions. So hope this will be of help to you. Just focus a bit more. If you have any questions, you can write in the comments and I'll try to sort them out. Anyway, so question number one is write a number in each box so that the calculation is correct. First of all, we see a number plus 357 is equal to 486. So what we should do, we should do the opposite to find the answer. We should do the opposite. So we are doing here plus 357. So instead of doing plus 357 on the other side with the answer, we should do minus 357. Okay, so we'll borrow from here. This will be 7, this will be 16. 16 minus 7 is 9, 7 minus 5 is 2, 4 minus 3 is 1. The answer is 129. Plus 357 will give you 486. Same thing we do with the other question. A number times 23 will give you 1840. The opposite of times is division. So what we should do, we should divide 1840 by 23. So this will give you and a zero, 80. The answer will be 80. 1840 divided by 23 will give you 80. The answer is 80. Let's move to question number two. They are saying here are four cards. Each card has a number on it. The four cards are arranged to make number 2745. Show how the cards can be arranged to make smallest number using all four cards. Whenever you see a question like these, try to arrange these cards in ascending order, yani from small to big. If you arrange them in that order, automatically the number you will get will be the smallest possible number. So the smallest number here is 2, then after 2 we have a 4, then 5 and 7, and this is the smallest possible number. Second one, show how the cards can be arranged to make an even number using all four cards. To make a number even, you should know the last digit should be an even number, and here we have two even numbers, 4 and 2. So let's put any of these in the last box. So let's put 4 here. So, and other numbers, you can put them in any order, doesn't matter. So let's put it like 2, 7, 5, 4, and that's an even number. Let's move to the next page. The bar chart gives information about the area in millions of hectares of the land used in 5 countries to grow rice. You can see on the left hand side of the graph here we have the area, how much area these countries are using, and on the below on the x-axis you see the countries Bangladesh, Vietnam, Cambodia, China, India and Thailand. For Thailand there is no graph. I think we will need to draw a graph. They will ask us in a question. So let's go to the questions. They are saying, in which of these 5 countries are 7 million hectares of land used to grow the rice? 7 million, I think it must be somewhere around here. So which one? I think, yeah, this one. So Vietnam. Answer number A is Vietnam. Okay. Then question B, how many million of hectares of land are used to grow rice in China? How much land they are using in China? If you will see the bar of China exactly on 30, so 30 millions of hectares of land are being used in China. Now they are saying in Thailand 10 million hectares of land are used to grow rice. Draw a bar on the bar chart to show this information. We know 10 is till this line, so the bar of Thailand should look something like this. It's better that you use a pencil during the exam or any other test. Okay, so this is the bar chart for Thailand. More land is used to grow rice in India than in Cambodia. How many millions of hectares more So let's go and see the chart first. They are saying more land is used in India than Cambodia. Obviously, the bar of Cambodia is so small. I think it's like on three. And the bar of India is on 42 and a half or 43, I can say. So they're saying how much more. So the area of India, take away the area of Cambodia. The answer is 40. So it's 40 hectare more. They're asking to show us the working out here. 43 minus 3, 40 millions of hectares more. Let's move on to the next page. Okay, write 0.73 as a fraction. Give you a fraction in its simplest form. 0.72 will be written as, because we have two decimal numbers. Whenever you have two decimal numbers, it means it's tenths place value and hundredths place value. So it's hundredths. We have hundredths. It means we have 72 hundredths. Or you can just figure out that after decimal we have two values, so we will have two zeros in our denominator with one. So if you will have like one value, if it's just 0.7, which you can say 7/10, just one value, it will be 7/10. Same way here, we have two values, so it's 72 hundredths. And now we have to simplify it. So let's simplify it by the table of 4. So 4 times 1 is 4, 32, 4 times 8 is 32, 4 times 25. I think we cannot simplify it anymore. So the final simplified answer is 18 over 25. They're saying, write 3 over 4 as a percentage. Whenever we convert a fraction into a percentage, we multiply it by 100. And now we can simplify it. 4 times 1, 4 times 25. 3 times 25 will give you 75%. And then they're asking us to figure out 65% of 720. 65% can also be written as 65 over 100. Of is multiply of 720. 0 cancels 0. It's like dividing by 10. And then we can simplify it by the table of 5. 5 times 2. 5 times 13. Then 2 and 72, 2 times 1, 2 times 36. And then we'll multiply 13 with 36. We will get 468. Let's move on to the next question. Write these numbers in order of size. Start with the smallest first. You can't compare them now because they all are written in different ways. This one is in decimal, then we have a fraction, a percentage, and a fraction again, and a decimal. So first of all, we have to decide we will change them all into which form. So I think we should change them all in decimals. So first, we already have a 0.43. Here we already have 0.427. okay. Now we have to convert 9 over 20, 40.5%, and 4 over 9 in decimals. So 9 over 20 means 9 divided by 20. 9 divided by 20, when you will do in your calculators, 9 divided by 20, you will get 0.45. 40.5% is 40.5 out of 100. So when we divide something by 100, decimal moves back two steps. So this one will become 0.405. 40.5% is actually 40.5 over 100. Percent is always out of 100. And the last one, 4 over 9 means 4 divided by 9, which will give you 0.444. Now we have all the decimals, but something can confuse you people here. These are three decimal numbers, but these are only two. So let's make them easy to compare. Just give them a zero in the end. Now you can easily compare them. Let's see now which one is the smallest one. Smallest one is 0.405, which is in actual 40.5%. Now second one is 0.427, which is already in decimal, 0.427. then we have 0.430, which is actually already in decimal, 0.43. the next one is 0.444, which is 4 over 9. And the last one is the biggest one, which is 9 over 20, 0.450. This is how we convert different types of numbers, values in order. Let's move to the next page. Here is a centimeter grid. It means each box is a centimeter box. On the grid, draw a rectangle with a perimeter of 14 centimeter. Perimeter means when we add all the sides. It means when we will have a perimeter, and when we add all the sides, it will be 14. Remember, opposite sides are equal in a rectangle. So if I say this one is 5 and 5, which is equal to 10, and if this one is 2 and 2, which is equal to 4, so the perimeter will be 14. So we need to make a rectangle in such a way. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1, 2. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. This one is the rectangle with a perimeter of 14. On the other hand, they're asking us to draw a right angle triangle with an area of 12 centimeter square. Formula for area of a triangle is base times height divided by 2. Okay, so which is equal to 12. So we have to look for a base. Let's say if we take base of 4, and we need to look for height. Let's say if we take height of 6, or base of 6 and height of 4, same thing, which will give you 24, and then we divide it by 2, it will give you 12. So 6 and 4. So let's say the base is 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the height is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and because it's a perpendicular, that's the height of your triangle. Usually in right angle triangle, this line is considered as height. In other triangles, height, you have to figure out the perpendicular height. So this is 6, this is 4, and now we connect. So that's a right angle triangle with the area of 12 centimeter square. Here's temperature in each of 5 Canadian cities, one day in January. Vancouver, 6 degrees. Edmonton, negative 8 degrees. Yellowknife, negative 23. Quebec, negative 20. And Ottawa, negative 5. Work out the difference between the temperature in Vancouver and the temperature in Edmonton. Vancouver and Edmonton. The difference. Difference means we have to subtract Vancouver minus, and in Edmonton is negative 8. So 6 minus negative 8 degree. Minus, you know, whenever two negative signs come in front of each other, minus and minus changes to plus. So it will become 6 plus 8. 6 plus 8 is 14. So the difference between Vancouver and Edmonton is 14 degree. The temperature in Yellowknife is lower than the temperature in Ottawa. How much lower? Temperature in Yellowknife is lower than in Ottawa. Yes, it is. You can see Yellowknife is colder, but how much lower? So we have to find the difference between negative 5 and negative 23. Negative 5 and negative 23. The difference means we have to minus. Anyways, again, minus minus comes in front of each other, so it will become like this. Negative 5 minus minus will change to plus 23. Okay, minus 5 plus 23, in this case we will subtract. Okay, but the sign will be positive, so it will be 17 degree. The difference is 18 degree. The difference is 18 degree. Next question. The temperature in Winnipeg was 8 degree greater than the temperature in Quebec. Work out the temperature in Winnipeg. It's 8 degree greater than in Quebec, and Quebec has a negative 20 plus 8, negative 20 plus 8 will give you negative 12. So the temperature in Winnipeg will be negative 12 degrees centigrade. We have finished 5 different questions. Let's end this part here. We'll solve the rest of the questions in the next part. I hope this video is of help to you. If you want me to solve any of the questions, let me know in the comments, and have a nice day.